Certainly after September 11, our world has changed. But at the same time, I see American people really coming together, and I see the camaraderie and the fellowship that hasn't been there. I see it now.
I think that was a terrible, terrible deal happening in New York. I mean, that puts me close to the people there because they're Americans, and I'm American.
When the good Lord gives you the first breath, it's already determined what you're going to be. You might not know it, but it's already determined.
Tumbling, sifting through the remains. Everyone saying that the world has changed. And the widow cries from sorrow. The sailor from regret. And I wonder about tomorrow, cause I haven't cried yet.
Biking across the country, and it took us about, I don't know, I think I've been training 6 days for this. How would you feel?
A little tired. I haven't slept for about 40 hours.
North Dakota is going to be
so comfortable.
I have no idea.
I'm going to breeze right through this.
2,000 miles in a punt.
I might even do it in 2 days. That's the type of guy I am.
Danny's running the show. But I'm sort of like, you know, I kind of keep it together. I'm like the sergeant of arms, I'm calling myself. I've been self-elected.
You say it.
It's done.
We do it.
We do it. Got it? Loves you, baby. Give me a kiss.
Our mission is to thank the people, spread the love, be righteous, and make it, on a personal level, get to the coast.
We have a unique opportunity to go and thank everybody that came by our house and made it a little better for us.
We lost 10 members from our house, and we're doing it for them.
I'm just looking to do my small part, you know, support the five guys riding, and you know, let them know that I am there for anything they need.
September 11th, I was home, sleeping on the couch. I had a guest with me, a friend of mine, she stays with me once in a while. And she woke me up, a plane flew into the World Trade Center.
For some reason I put on AM radio, I think I've put on AM radio in a long time. And right away I looked up and I mentioned my mom in the morning how beautiful of a day it was.
I saw a fire blowing out of four sides of the World Trade. 10 stories in depth, and I'm like, yeah, that's no small plane.
This flag is off my father's gravesite.
No, I have
it's the reason why this is on. Everything I have on me is for a reason. Whether it be a pin, whether it be a medal, whether it be John Deere's card, so everything is a reason for what we're doing. This is a veteran flag, straight out of Long Island National Cemetery.
I'm not going to be around for Thanksgiving or her birthday, and let me tell you, Chelsea, can we get everybody to sing Chelsea happy birthday before
happy
I go?
Happy birthday to you.
Cha-cha-cha.
Happy birthday to you.
Cha-cha-cha.
Happy birthday, dear Chelsea.
Cha-cha-cha.
Happy birthday to you.
Yay! Love you, Dad.
As you get closer, it gets darker and darker and darker, and it's finally when you're down there, it's just like you just pulled into midnight.
We had a smoke, heavy smoke condition. It was banked down to, I guess, your ankles. There was debris flying everywhere. The most bizarre sound that I heard was nothing.
And then when you get closer to the pile, you know, you're not digging like dirt and like, you know, you're digging like scraps of everything. It's just not like, it's not diggable.
Someone would imagine they heard something, or, you know, I don't know, but every now and again, you hear people going, I got one, you know, there's a live one.
Brothers are looking down right now, and they're very proud of us. We're doing this for them.
Please let me make a difference before I die. Please let me do something brilliant before I
die. Hey, the gate is now 8:48. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, amen. Almighty God, bestow your blessings on this drive of five. We dedicate this particular cross-country journey in the honor of their comrades of 33-9, all the firefighters, all the police officers, Port Authority, and all those who lost their lives here September 11th of this year. Bless these five outstanding men. Bless them all in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, now and forever. Amen.
Let's do it!
Let's go, America! Let's go, guys! That's right!
It's a great way to say thank you to some of the other fire departments and people across the United States who felt so much pain and suffering for what took place here in New York City, and especially for the firefighters.
Take my voice, rise up like a phoenix, make me louder than war and death and hate combined. Sing my prayers, ring them straight through the rafters, silence the violence that fills our minds. Something brilliant. Hey, can we do something different? I know we're 5 billion people with one lonely try, running out, running out of time.
40 miles, didn't you? Like 40, you felt like four.
We are here.
Well, they're from New York, and that's like a one-time thing that you get autographs from firefighters that were at Ground Zero. So far, I only got two, but I hope to get like everybody from New York that's here.
Dan, I want to introduce you to Dan.
Hey there, Dan.
I think he would like some signatures.
Yes, you want a signature?
Sure.
Yeah.
I'm Gerard, by the way.
Where,
what's
Philly?
Up, Dan?
Oh, G-Rod.
What's your last name?
Gillian.
Sam Hill.
Dan
Gillian.
There
he is. There he is.
Hey, he's a probie!
He needs his neck rubbed over here.
Hey, when you're done rubbing, rub over here.
Everybody's sad because of what happened. And all they want to do is, you know, support us. You know, because everybody's so sad that they just want to make us happy.
We ended up leaving from Great Jones Street around 7:30. And pulling into Philly around 10:30. And I think we were quite a bit later than we anticipated to be. But as cold as it was, as late as it was, you know, the street up to the firehouse was lined for a couple of blocks with people waiting to welcome us. And it was just very impressive.
America cares about, you know, not just firemen and stuff, just cares about, you know, people in general, and they come out and they do the right thing. It's just, you know, America's a great country.
As a captain of the station, I'm thrilled to have these guys here. Well, if it means as much to other people as it means to me, they're doing a whole lot of goodwill, I'll tell you.
On Sunday, November 11th at 8:48 a.m. Eastern Standard Time, exactly 2 months after the first plane hit the World Trade Center, six firefighters from engine company number 33 in New York City embarked on the FDNY Thank You America bike tour. Dan Rowan, Sal Princiata, Drew Robb, Matt Hornung, and Gerard Dolan will stop at 100 firehouses as they make their way through 16 states to California. Guys, good morning. Nice to see you.
Morning,
good morning, Matt. What's up?
No, not a lot. Dan, let me start with you. And I think the best way for people to understand some of the feelings you had after September 11th is for you.
This is a special report from News Channel 4.
We're doing a little thing for the Today Show, saying how great everybody is. And then we go into the kitchen and we see it looks like a plane down.
This comes just about 2 months and a day after the September 11th World Trade Center,
No word on what brought this plane down. At the moment, we don't know whether this was simply an accident or something else. We're not going to jump to any conclusions.
I can't believe this is happening again.
Yeah, I just heard about the plane crash in Rockaway. What happened?
I'm praying for just mechanical failure.
Oh my God, is it hijacked again? What's going on?
Bill, it's no accident. Just too coincidental.
Did it come from the ocean, like around your house, or was it?
As everybody raced to the World Trade Center, now everybody's racing out to Rockaway.
How far into Rockaway is it? Is it close to the bridge?
I don't know what to do anymore. I want to go home. I want to be with your brothers. I want to be with my family.
So it's still unclear whether or not it has to do with any type of terrorist attack? They're not saying anything?
The sad, sad thing. New York City has just been so inundated with bad news.
But there's nothing we can do now but just say a prayer for our friends and you know, the people that are there.
And I'm going to ride for them now, too. I have to ride for everybody, and I'm going to ride for them. Put them right on my shoulder along with everybody else.
It just should be to continue, but, you know, it's just hard because I get a little flashback now. You know, there's that ground zero while two was falling, so, you know, I just have that feeling again. I mean, I want to continue and feel strong, but I just feel sad.
I feel so bad for them.
Yourself when you're getting up there. Almost there, baby. Gotta push it out, baby. Gotta push it out. No quit. No quit. And sometimes, you know, you don't always have to sit in the saddle. Sometimes you gotta get up just to give your legs like a different feel, you know? Oh. Doing good, brother. Doing good, man. We're almost there. We're almost at the top. You got it.
To sum up, hills, bad, flat, good.
We can't speed it up.
Okay, all right.
So this way, by the end of the day, we're going to stay together, but we're going to lose. By the end of the day, us three are going to be behind. That's it.
So for the first couple
of highway, it's dangerous.
But Sal, the only way we're going to do that, we got to ride single file. We have to ride. That's the only way.
I hear you. But my point is that you have to slow up.
Okay.
Weaker riders until we all get in shape, like you guys are in shape.
That's cool.
We'll do single file. The right way. Let's go. So we'll do single file.
We'll be right back.
D.C. mean to you, this part of the trip?
I think it's the best thing for them to see us coming from New York City, for a little bit of heart that we've got, not a little bit, a ton of heart that we got, and just saying we're sorry, and that's all it is. We're diplomats of heart. And that's about it. Where are you going?
Where were you September 11th? How'd you find out? What were you thinking then? You
know? Actually, really, I was home and I woke up and I caught it on the news, right? Because first I heard about the Pentagon. And then as the newscast went on, I found out about what happened in New York.
Then you hear about all the people that did get hurt. All you can do is shake your head and say, what kind of man is responsible for that?
Well, I was kind of like upset, but not really too upset at Bin Laden at first. Until it really touched me, because like I'm on a fixed income, and then by my checks being held up, and like to see it and put me back in hold on my rent and stuff like to see it, so I can see now how it really affected everybody in America.
Really, this is the first time in the history of the nation that the real work and service of these brave men and women and things even come on the radar screen.
Just a great feeling, you know? Hopefully we can make people happy and they make us happy, motivate us, we motivate them, keep this country trucking along, because no murderers are going to stop this country from trucking along.
People are looking for heroes, accessible heroes. And so our firefighters are everywhere, in every community, every house of worship. You name it, and you've got members of the fire service there, and so it's easy to identify with these special heroes.
I have a request. We have a funeral in New York for Keith Maynard. If we could offer a memorial prayer for him just briefly.
Yes, please.
Dear Heavenly Father, as we celebrate the homegoing of your faithful servant, Keith Maynard, in New York City, be with those...
Just to deal with the fallen firefighters, the 343 in one fell swoop, couldn't help but deeply impact the spirit of these firefighters.
Forever, and your truth to all generations. Amen. Amen.
We're feeling as much pain as they are. And for them, they're opening up their city and their hearts for us. This is a phenomenal thing. This is the nation right here.
A lot of murders in one day, you know? You know, I didn't know anybody here, but, you know, they're victims and they were murdered just like our people in New York. They were just murdered. Right now I'm mad, you know? Pissed off right now. They got into this place too. Devastating.
I mean, they know what we went through. I know what they went through. And it's a tragedy, it's a disaster that hopefully will never ever happen again. I hope we get some good out of this. Maybe it'll bring the whole nation together.
You had a good night's sleep, man?
Yeah.
Yeah?
Very good. That's what it's all about. Get a good night's sleep and head out on the highway.
When I walked in this far east this morning and saw that and heard that they were here,
I know.
You don't know how I felt. You just don't know. Well, I came in the fire company in 1944 when I came in, and I've been active ever since. If you don't have love for one another, you can know what's going to happen. And you've seen what happened. It was a blessing. It really was a blessing. to know that we got people cared enough to have them to come through and stop here to see us.
How do you do?
Great town you guys got out of your farm at the back across America.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
Oh, God. Best food in this planet.
Yeah, we're having a good time.
I have my grits.
Hey, get on in here.
Hey, Drew.
Hey.
Go ahead.
Hey, we're starting out here with 0 miles, and we're going to go all the way, sir. How many miles are we going to be? 2,000 now. Hey, 2,000 miles we've come already, and we're going to go all the way. Anybody going for three? We've come 2,000, start at ground zero, up to 2,000. All right, let's grow. Two now, three, four. Yes.
Yeah. Where is Jeffrey? Where is David?
Certainly after September 11, our world has changed. I think we have tended to get away from a lot of our values that we should have had, and not for the better. It takes something really catastrophic to make us change.
This is the first time that I've had to deal with dying. Going back to New York after I'm done here and being in some sort of catastrophe. A building falling down, being on a plane that falls. I never had the fear then that I do now. So, patriotism has a whole new meaning.
I love these New York people. I was in New York last weekend. And I went down to Ground Zero. There was a park ranger there. And I walked up and asked him where the buildings used to be on the skyline. And he just kind of looked up and pointed right there.
Buildings don't have life cycles so short, especially, you know, buildings that are monuments, you know, landmarks. And it amazes me that in my lifetime this has happened. They gotta be tired.
I feel like we should be honored that they chose to come through Charlottesville on their journey. It would mean a lot to meet them because they've been through a whole lot and they keep going on. I personally believe that it should be served as a memorial, but of course, the market's going to speak to that, as they've already shown us that they're already trying to rebuild the towers, where there's been taught to rebuild the towers the way they were. And I feel that not building it the way it was would be more of defiance than to go ahead and reproduce what was already there. I don't think they should be built right back on top of it. I think that's kind of, in my opinion, I think it's disrespectful. It should be a place of memorial.
Call the angels who didn't make it.
Love to be on the bikes, but it's not my core. It's not my day to bike ride anymore. Dude, it's got five strong guys bike riding, and it's gonna be a long trip for them. And you know, I'm proud of what I'm doing. I'm answering the phones. We had 110 phone calls today in the support van.
I'm just looking to do my small part.
I'll take care of the big boy here.
It's not time to make a change. Just relax, take it easy. You're still young, that's your fault. There's so much you have to go through. Find a girl, settle down. And if you want, you can marry. Look at me, I am old, but I'm happy.
This is from Justin Balmar. He came here today to give us a letter, and the letter says, "Dear NYFD, I'm very sorry that some of the firefighters died. My name is Justin Balmar at Brookville Middle School. All of your fire departments are my heroes. One of your firefighters..."
These people don't even know who we are. This is what it's all about, you know? It's him. That's what it's all about. This is why you have to get out and do what we have to do.
I mean, I don't think there's a half hour time span go by where I don't think about what went down since it's over 2 months now. It's just in my mind constantly.
Well, I understand fully what they're feeling. Approximately 7 years ago, I was involved in an officer-involved shooting in which the suspect shot at me point-blank range and missed. However, the other officer there was shot in the head and killed. So I know what they're feeling as far as the guilt feeling of why not me, why somebody else. I know exactly the way they feel, and it stays with you.
I think about Mikey all the time. I think about John Deere all the time. I dream about Mike Boyle, Dave Arcee all the time, you know, all the rest of the guys.
You know, maybe it's survivor's guilt, you know? Who knows what it is, you know? It could be survivor's guilt, which is probably what it is, you know?
Mind over matter right now.
Could sense how much energy is behind this ride that we're doing, because I couldn't do this ride without just kind of, you know, the memory of my uncle and all those souls that are up there pushing us. I feel the guys pushing us. I feel it.
My mother would say, "Remember the tale of the little train that was climbing the hill that said, I think I can. And then when it got almost to the top, it was saying, I know I can. Maybe it's the other way around, I don't know. But you get the point.
This is what my brothers must have felt like climbing the World Trade.
It's 5 minutes away from 8 o'clock on the Big Dog 103.1 WIKQ. It's Dr. John and Ray and the Clock Watchers Show, and we are pleased to welcome one of New York City's finest. Tell them your name, please, sir.
My name is Salvatore Quinciana, and it's the bravest one.
The finest of the police officers. We're the bravest.
I'm sorry.
That's who
you are. There you are.
I just drink that out.
Fantastic. Well, welcome to Greenville. We are pleased to have you here.
Welcome to be here. Great town.
Let's get a little serious. You were at Ground Zero?
Yeah, I live in Manhattan, so I headed down south when the first plane hit. We lost 10 men from our firehouse, engine 33, ladder 9.
God bless you for your loss, and God bless you for what you've done, and you are an American hero, my friend.
Thank you very much.
We're proud to have you.
To see the energy that surrounds them as they come into town, all the people that were here to welcome them, meeting and greeting and going across the country is very valuable at getting people to get on with their lives. I think it gives people a connection, you know, local people here. We've seen it on TV. We've not been at Ground Zero. I think it gives people a connection of New York, and they see that in their eyes.
Thank you.
some New York City Fire Department firemen that all were on the scene on September the 11th. Chose Knoxville as one of the stops and particularly wanted to come out and see the Tennessee Volunteers. The events of September the 11th, guys, as we've talked about a number of times, has brought our country and our people closer together than maybe ever in the history, or at least in recent history. And out of a tragedy has come a lot of good. And we thank y'all for taking your time to come and spend with us, okay?
Thanks for having us. It's helping us heal. It's helping everybody else heal. But it's also living. I'm moving personally on in my life here, just enjoying every moment. You know, seizing the moment. You know, these are the good old days.
Father, we just want to pause on this day of Thanksgiving to thank you for all that you've done for us. Thank you for each family represented here. Father, we thank you for our guests from New York.
I'm grateful that the sacrifices that were made weren't in vain. They never should have been called for, but at least they served.
I do have the opportunity to hold my kids, and I do have the opportunity to kiss my wife. These guys will never have the opportunity to do this ever again. So,
thank God, thank God I'm going home today. Thank God I'm, thank God I'm healthy, stuff like that. That's what goes through my head. I'm sure it goes through a lot of our, a lot of our heads. It has to. I mean, sometimes I think it makes you a better person because you maybe enjoy life a little more,
Job 33 years.
God bless.
Okay. Nice to meet you. How are you?
How you doing? Nice to meet you. How you doing?
Nice to meet you guys. God bless you.
Thank you.
33 years, I heard.
Oh, you're in some good companies there, huh?
My name is George Nazaroff. I spent 30 years in the New York Fire Department. Great city, New York. Chattanooga's a great city, too. I love this city. My two grandsons were born here. I retired in 1968. Air bicycle trip, I think, is wonderful. America really turned its heart out for the people in New York.
Are you saying a prayer for us coming down?
Can I ask you what it means to you to be an American?
To be an American? Is there anything better? Nothing better than being an American.
So my name is Don Wade, and I came from San Diego, California. And when this happened, I decided that I had to walk to New York City.
How's it going, brother?
I'm still 1,000 miles away, but I think I will make it. Every day when I get up, I wonder if I could take that next step, but I will. We need to pull together and stay together like we are. And I wonder why it took so long for us to pull together.
I said our friend suffered. This ain't nothing. This ain't what they went through. If it's called good, if it's the worst conditions, the better. It'll just make us remember.
We've had 3 days of rain, drizzle, little light rain, but today was a heavy, heavy downpour. We had a tough time, there was no doubt about that. Between the trucks passing us by, you couldn't get anywhere near the white lines because the bikes were sliding away. Then the wind started kicking up.
I kept saying the guys' names that we lost in our firehouse. Mike Boyle, Dave Arcee, Bobby King, Bobby Evans, Keith Maynard, Gerard Baptiste, Jeff Walsh.
Lieutenant Kevin Pfeiffer, Engine 33. Firefighter Brian Belcher, probationary firefighter John Kearney.
I want to walk in and make people smile and make people laugh and, you know, and enjoy people's company, you know.
The children are what makes this really, really work.
Well, we're here just to field your questions and to really thank every one of you for what you've done. The ribbons, like I said, the cards, the flowers, like just little signs that say, United we stand. When you sign that, means something.
As soon as we walked in, what were you guys studying on?
Social studies.
We left right from there. I don't want to mock up people. Right there, that's Long Island. That's part of New York.
We're gonna get from here to here, right about in here, in about 3 more weeks.
Ain't it hard pedaling all the way here?
Actually, once you get, let's just say, like the first 150 miles, your butt gets stuck to that seat and you don't feel it anymore.
So the students, a lot of them were not aware of the event until after school that afternoon because we wanted the parents to be able to tell them.
When you saw the fire, were you afraid?
A little bit, but we knew we had to do our job, which was go in there and get as many people out as you could, you know?
Good point. How did it look?
Bad. How did it look? Not too good. It looked very bad. I knew that there were a lot of people who didn't make it out alive, that was sad.
I had played hockey the week before with a guy that was lost. I had, you know, run a race with a few guys that, you know, 3 days before it happened, 2 days before it happened.
And my uncle, Chief Downing, was gone. You know, he's a man who was a, you know, total legend. He's a legend. He was a living legend. You know, the man that didn't brag, he didn't boast. He really, literally was a living legend. Now he's, you know, he's going to go down as one of America's, you know, a top American hero.
Everybody has strong emotions about going to Oklahoma City. I mean, that's the same thing that happened in the World Trade Center, terrorism on a smaller scale.
My name is Doris Jones, and we are at the Oklahoma City National Memorial in Oklahoma City. This was an act of violence. This was an intentional bombing of a building that had people in it. And they need to be remembered so that people realize when they go through the memorial that this could be you. It could be your town. It could be your city. It could have been anyone, anywhere. And it could be your son or your daughter. To know that so many of the firefighters, rescue workers that were here lost their lives in New York City. There's several of them that we, you know, that were here right after the bombing that recovered a lot of people here that have lost their lives now. If Sal can remember his uncle, the way that his uncle laughed, the way that he would tell a story, whatever it might be, the way he'd answer a phone, it's you just need to keep everything you can, because in time you'll forget what their voice sounded like.
What does this memorial represent to you?
To me, first of all, it's a place that my daughter died. It's a remembrance for those people that were lost here, that were killed. I shouldn't have said lost, because they're not lost. They were killed here. You know, my daughter was not one of 168. She was Carrie Lynn's, who had a life, who was just getting ready to start a family. You know, yeah, they need to be remembered. And there's not going to be any more memories, so you have to keep these memories, because this is all you've got. But God, couldn't you leave her here? Already gone, this I can't say.
Thought they had the wrong people as heroes. These sports figures and people like that that's on drugs and everything else and trying to make them role models for young kids. People like the firemen and policemen and the, all the service workers up there, that's true hero.
Thank you.
Then what do you think we should do about terrorism now?
They're going to have to turn the CIA and everything we got loose. Everybody, diplomacy, cut off their funding, assassinations, whatever it takes to stop it. You can't reason with people like that. The only thing they got in mind is your destruction. The only choice you have is to try to get them over there on their territory, you know, and keep them coming over here. It's a shame that it has to be that way, but you can't negotiate with people like that. And then maybe someday, hopefully in my lifetime, they'll get it down to where our people feel safe here. When you walk the streets and ride an airplane, and you don't have to worry about getting blown out of the sky or somebody blowing you up, then I'll know we've got the terrorist kind of in hand. But it's going to be years down the road, I believe.
My name's Dale Corcoran. We're in Old Mobity, Texas. The oldest town in the Texas Panhandle. My granddad, he lived here all of his life. My dad lived here all of his life, and I hadn't lived all my life here yet. It's devastating to think about 3,000 people, you know. And, well, population here is not but 100. And it's devastating when, you know, even two or three here get killed.
This is them a proclamation of our thanks to them for their commitment not only to New York City, but to their bravery and what they have shown us as Americans, and thank them for coming to Pampa, Texas, and letting us get to know them. But more than anything, I just wanted to say to you guys, We can say you guys here in Texas, okay?
But y'all.
Y'all, okay?
Y'all, it's good. I learned that. What's the plural of y'all?
Yeah.
All y'all.
Oh, yeah.
Y'all, welcome to Texas.
Team Houston. This is our southern contingent that actually drove 12 hours to meet us. They don't know who we are. We don't know who they are. But them coming to us, we're all brothers and sisters to the end of time. They've taken us through the whole state of Texas. They didn't have to do this. They wanted to do this.
September the 11th taught everybody one thing, is tomorrow's not guaranteed. We as firefighters, we commit to take everybody home the next day to see their families again. And that doesn't happen all the time. So just remember the love, that tomorrow is not guaranteed, this afternoon's not guaranteed. Live for the moment.
Hey, I met you. It looks familiar.
What it taught me, the September 11th event, or what it taught me is maybe not so much to live in fear, but to live in love and to love more deeply. Will I not be able then, for the rest of this day and this week and next month, to be able to extend more courtesy and more empathy to other people, and then they go out and do the same to other people? So it's
think this trip is going to do, it's going to clean me all out emotionally. You know, I just think it's just going to be a cover up for a little while. It's not going to do, I'm not going to go home, hey, the life is great again, you know. My uncle's still gone, my friends are still dead.
Closure? Nah. There's never going to be closure. How's it going to be closure? Your friends are gone. Seems to me every time I think of my friends, I see them smiling. I mean, I don't see how you could get closure, really.
You can have as much time as you want, but the healing process takes a lot longer than just 2,500 miles. You know, so.
Good luck.
Thank you, sir.
September 11, I was getting ready in the morning to go to work in Santa Fe. And I had my TV on, and as I was getting ready, I watched to the horror of what was happening. And I just began to cry. And I was crying, and I was crying, and it still makes me feel very sad. You know, thinking is really a great responsibility, and it's a great deed among our native people. So I think it's really great because they're giving of themselves physically, spiritually, psychologically, all of these things that make, in our Navajo way, makes a person into a balanced person.
Hey, oh, hey.
have songs like that that are kind of that are chants, and they're made to primarily just keep the heart beating and keep to replenish the soul. And the song is called America Anye, which in our language in Carisan is Anye means beautiful. So basically, it's America the Beautiful.
Flying home tomorrow for my uncle's mess, and then I'm gonna fly back.
Well, we have to push to Phoenix to get him. That's why we're gonna be pushing a little harder. He's been riding with a heavy heart, you know, for 2,400 miles or so. So you gotta give the guy a lot of credit. Man's pushing hard, and he's still going.
I got a nice day at least.
Where we are is 90 miles west of Phoenix. Is your only stretch of nothingness, and there's no town, and so hence the need for what we're doing here, a little dinky fire department out on the Colorado River trying to help this megalopolis fire department. And even in some small way that we are doing it here, it just thrills the living hell out of me, you know, absolutely just touches my heart, you know.
Less than 180 miles to the final destination of Pasadena. We're going to do that in 3 days. Today, tomorrow, and Sunday.
You have no idea how happy I am to be in California. The sun always shines in California. Whatever you do, we just so happy to be here.
With the firemen.
You know, we just did like 2,600, so we're all set.
California has been my second favorite state since with the exception of New York as being number one. But now that I got to meet everybody personally and every state that we've been through, they're all my favorite states. Thanks, guys.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear Pappy. Happy birthday to you.
Thank you all very much.
Thank you.
You've heard on the news that the bicycle fellows driving their bikes across country from New York were going to arrive in Palm Springs, so we certainly wanted to come out and greet them.
Love you, love you.
Congratulations.
I made it all the way down.
I don't believe you guys went across town like that. Across the
country. It's all across town. It's all across town.
Yeah,
it's like going
Brooklyn
through
Brooklyn to Manhattan,
yeah,
right?
No problem.
Same thing.
Do it all
over the bridge.
Over the bridge.
This is the year of sacrifice. It's the year of sacrifice. People had to make sacrifices, whether to be their lives, the loss of their loved ones, friends. Everybody sacrifices in one way, shape, or form.
September 11th, I give up everything. I give up 10 years of my life to bring my guys back. And the rest of the FDNY, PD, all the people on board the plane. Just to wake up and now that has happened.
They brought a piece of New York to me that I was not able to grasp.
Miles between doesn't seem to affect anybody. Everybody cares.
Times of disaster and times of fear, the human spirit is the one that unites everybody.
This has been wonderful to see Old Glory flying, just to see how people have come together, really.
It allows us to express our sympathy, and it allows us to feel the emotion that has been down real deep inside, and it's a release for us.
Awesome, guys! Great job!
I don't think nobody ever forget where they were on September 11th.
You just gotta deal with what's happened and help in any way that you can.
They just don't know it. I don't think they'll ever know how much they've touched us, the whole United States.
Today is an emotional up because what we've accomplished that I hope just doesn't end. I hope our emotional high stays emotionally high. Not just for myself, for the team of guys that I'm with, for the United States.
Thanking everybody for all the generosity that had been shown us, and it's been absolutely overwhelming right now.
Everybody's hearts have been out there for us, everybody's hands have been in the air, everybody's been clapping, everybody's been cheering us on.
Just America's an awesome place, man. People are really, really nice. And I'm glad to live here, totally.